Hello, I'm Eva from the Vector Support Team. If you have a new vector license that is not recognized by your vector software product, we are sorry about that, but I have some hints that resolve most of the issues. These are also the first items we check together when you contact the vector support, and they really solve the majority of cases. You should have carried out an activation. I've demonstrated this online activation on another tutorial, which you can find on the Vector Knowledge Base. If you see an error message like this when you start the Vector software product, please check the following three items. The latest driver version, the latest software service pack, and the latest Vector license client version. How can we check quickly if we are up to date? First, check your driver version. Go to Control Panel, Vector Hardware, Help and About. To check for updates, click on Support and Check Internet for Updates. This leads you to the Vector homepage. In the download preview of the latest Vector driver setup, the latest version of the Vector hardware config is listed. In this case, we are up to date because our version is the same as listed here. If you need to go to another computer to get internet access, you can use the shortcut vector.com/latest-driver to get here. So we go to the next step and check the software service pack version. We can see our software version, here KINU is an example, already in the splash screen during startup. If KINU is running already, go to File and Help and read out the version with a service pack. On vector.com, you find the latest version through the shortcut Service Packs and by setting a filter for your product. Finally, I sort by date to see the latest one on the top. Again, we are up to date. By the way, all supported software versions are listed in our compatibility list on our Vector Knowledge Base. So we check for the option 3, the version of the Vector License Client, the software that manages all licenses of the new Vector License model on the client side. We start the Vector License Client from the Windows Start menu. I type License and select the License Client, not the Manager. During Start, we already see the version. If we missed this, we can find it in the About section, which is located behind the green eye. Versions from 4.2 onwards check for updates automatically when they can connect to the Vector License Activation Server. The latest version of the Vector License Client is also available from vector.com. Alternatively, to searching for the name, you get directly to the zip download link with the shortcut vector.com/VLC. The installer is named with a version. Also here we have the latest version installed. If you should need to update any of these three components, it is important to execute the installer with administrator rights. If this still doesn't work, please do not hesitate to contact my colleagues and me through the Vector customer portal or under support@vector.com, and we will be happy to support you further as fast as possible. Helpful information for that is the Vector license ID of the software, the serial number of the hardware, and a screenshot of the error message. More information on Vector licensing topics you can find on our Vector Knowledge Base under kb.vector.com/licensing.